From the moment the national team took the stage in Paris, fans were ecstatic. Officially, the team must compete under the name Chinese Taipei to sidestep the issue of Taiwan's political status. But as the team floated down the Seine, a French TV anchor declared that this team came from Taiwan. Fans were unable to believe their ears. This was the start of a Games marked by a swelling of pride in the face of what many Taiwanese saw as moves to belittle their nation. There were moments of bitter disappointment. 30-year-old weightlifter Guo Xingjun fought back tears after getting bronze and failing to defend her title in what may be her last Games. She had struggled to recover from long-standing injuries. But there were also moments of sheer joy. For the second Games in a row, badminton duo Li Yang and Wang Qilin beat China for the gold. China claims Taiwan and regularly threatens the country with military force. But on the badminton court, at least, the Taiwanese underdogs had triumphed.
能再次站上颁奖台，然后又可以让国旗哥在会场去做播放，我们真的觉得非常的感动。那那一刻真的是又哽咽。那时候我们真的很感谢现场所有观众跟支持者嘛，然后在荧幕后面的所有人，因为他们的鼓励，我们才可以继续在场上坚持。Taiwan's
dignity is always a touchy issue at the games. Like the name Taiwan, the country's national flag and anthem are both nowhere to be found. But this year, things got especially heated, as even signs of support for Taiwan's athletes were confiscated, some by Olympic officials, others by angry Chinese supporters. And then there was the case of boxer Lin Yuting. In addition to her rivals, Lin had to overcome a wave of online abuse over rumors about her gender, rumors the IOC says are unfounded. Big names who weighed in included Harry Potter author J.K. Rowling. But in Lin's hometown of New Taipei, fans, including the mayor, gathered to watch her take Taiwan's first ever gold in boxing. In the end, Taiwan won just 2 gold and 5 bronze medals, not its best showing. But even without a national flag to rally around, Taiwanese fans have come together around their sporting champions, who've shown that despite its small size, Taiwan can still punch above its weight. Luffy Lee and John Van Trieste for Taiwan Plus.